buy it, try and get it in these bunches with the tops. You can tell the condition of the fennel by the tops for a start. And it makes a nice garnish, so it's really useful to have. Fennel doesn't always look beautiful. When you see it, it can have dry. Sometimes the skin's really bumpy, or it looks bruised, or it's got little nicks. That doesn't mean it's not going to be good fennel. Check it always by pressing it around with your thumb. Make sure there's no soft spots on it. It should have a nice firm look to it. I'll cut off one fennel bulb. The one thing with fennel is that it will discolour quite quickly, so if you're going to make it ahead, you need to put it into dressing fast. We just want to take these tops off first, so just cut those right off. This is, if you're cooking fish, this is great to, on barbecue or something, it's great to throw these onto the fire, and it'll just give fish in particular really suits that flavour. So I'm going to have to take this outer layer off because it's a little bit bruised. And you sometimes need to give it a bit of a wash, but we'll just peel that layer off. We're now going to cut it in half and take out this core that's in the centre of the fennel. It's usually quite tough and a bit coarse, so get that out of the fennel to start with. Same on this side. We're going to cut this down into nice fine rounds. Now, if you have difficulty using a chef's knife, then use these little serrated knives, work just as well. But if you're going to have fennel raw, you want it to be really a nice fine little slivers so that they coat nicely in the dressing, but also it's just appearance wise and taste wise, it's got a much better flavour. It's fine and feathery. Fennel's a beautiful vegetable cooked. One terrific thing you can do with these is when you have them at this stage before we slice them is to just blanch them for about 10 minutes or just till they're just tender, then put them into a buttered gratin dish, put over a little more butter, some freshly grated parmesan and some salt and pepper and pop them in the oven about 400 degrees for 20 minutes. It's just a wonderful dish.